After the Lord Jesus had spoken to them, he was taken up into heaven and sat down at the right hand of God. Good morning. Welcome to a short biblical reflection on the passage from the Gospel according to Mark, chapter 16, verses 14 up to 20. It is about the appearing Jesus to the disciples and commissioning the 11 and the ascension of Jesus. In the lectionary, the reading starts right from verse 15, but they are the words of commission given to the disciples. And he said to them, "Go into the world and preach the gospel to every creature. The one who believes and is baptized will be saved, but the one who does not believe will be condemned." And leaving behind the introductory words that should also be included, therefore I start from verse 14 because it prepares for this contradiction, for belief and unbelief. Then he appeared to the 11 themselves while they were eating, and he rebuked them for their unbelief and hardness of heart, because they did not believe those who had seen him resurrected. After the words of commission, Jesus also gives assurance that there will be signs which will accompany them, that there will be the miracles. And this concept is retaken in the concluding verse. They went out and proclaimed everywhere, while the Lord worked with them and confirmed the word through the accompanying signs. By going out and proclaiming the gospel, the disciples fulfill now the mission, as well also they demonstrate it, their faith, and therefore Jesus is accompanying them with the miracles, with the signs. And the reading dedicates to the ascension on one verse, the one which I quoted right at the beginning. After the Lord Jesus had spoken to them, he was taken up into heaven and sat down at the right hand of God. Therefore, the fact of ascension has not so much importance in this reading as the commission and this contradiction between belief and unbelief. In other words, this reading does not present ascension itself only. Ascension is linked to the mission that the disciples now must fulfill. Jesus is leaving them physically, but he is with them, working through them. And now the disciples have to take the mission of Jesus, proclaiming the gospel. The contrast between belief and unbelief is essential in this reading. Therefore, now I would like to see how this contrast, this contradiction is fitting in overall flow of the story in the Gospel according to Mark, since these verses are the concluding verses of the Gospel according to Mark. I'm not going to discuss and take into consideration the scholarly opinions concerning those verses. Right from the very first words of Jesus, the faith is stressed, as we read at the beginning of the Gospel. Now, after John was imprisoned, Jesus went into Galilee and proclaimed the Gospel of God. He said, "The time is fulfilled and the kingdom of God is near. Repent and believe the Gospel." I pick up also two healing stories which are meaningful. The first one in chapter 5, the healing of the daughter of the synagogue ruler after receiving the information that she has died. Jesus is addressing the ruler of the synagogue. "Do not be afraid, just believe." Even more meaningful is the second healing story in chapter 9, healing of a boy with a spirit, because there is this contradiction between belief and unbelief. Jesus is addressing him, "If you are able, all things are possible for the one who believes." Immediately the father of the boy cried out and said, "I believe, help my unbelief." The last selected text, it concerns the withered fig tree when Jesus is addressing the disciples. "Have faith in God. I tell you the truth. If someone says to these mountains, be lifted up and thrown into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes that what he says will happen, it will be done for him. For this reason, I tell you, whatever you pray and ask for, believe that you will receive it, and it will be yours. In this brief overall view of the message of the Gospel according to Mark, focusing on faith, it shows how these concluding verses are fitting to overall message, because from the beginning of the Gospel, Jesus stressed belief in the Gospel, and now these concluding verses show that still, even during the time when Jesus is appearing, the disciples are still showing their unbelief, their hardness of heart. Therefore, Jesus now is stressing that they must believe. And then the concluding verses show this transformation. They take seriously these words, they believe, they go out, they proclaim the gospel, and the Lord is accompanying them with the signs. The words of Jesus in this commission sounds very strongly. The one who believes and is baptized will be saved, but the one who does not believe will be condemned. And in application, we could also pose a question, firstly to ourselves: do we really believe, or how do we believe? Do we really take these words seriously? For example, reflecting on the current situation, on the occasion of Easter, I saw some pictures posted by friends, mostly here by Italian friends in Italian, with Jesus who wants to go out from the tomb on the day of the resurrection, and the guard is telling him, Jesus, do not get out because of the pandemic situation, there is lockdown. Like the one who prepared such an image wanted to stress that at your time it was possible for you to be risen, but not in our time. In our time you cannot do anything. Probably reading within lines we could say, yes, at that time of Jesus there was belief, but now is there belief in our times that God is existing, that God is acting, or we are taking now everything in very naturalistic way? Because even interpretations of the Bible in modern times are done also from this point of view, very naturalistic, stripping the Gospels, stripping the Bibles from divine elements. For example, just mentioning at the conclusion, there was, I'm not sure if still continues, a famous group at the end of the 20th century, in 80s, 90s, called Jesus Seminar. Very nice name. However, the members of this group, generally starting with faith as the Biblists, they ended up with unbelief, considering Jesus only as a human, not divine. I would like to wish you a nice day, nice reflection on these words of Jesus of commission. The one who believes and is baptized will be saved.